You are looking inside a brand new factory-sealed iPhone 17 Pro telephoto lens. And yes, it is full of dust. Apple won't replace these because this level of dust is considered normal. But the dust, as shocking as it isn't even the most incredible thing I found. The print quality on the packaging is itself a technical feat. It's a perfect dot matrix of pixels. The seals are intact. This is 100% a new, unopened product. But look at the paper corner of the box. The precision of that fold is the first sign of manufacturing tolerances we should expect. It's impressive. You can feel the dense texture of this paper shimmering as the camera shifts angles. When we tear that seal, you can see the two-layer paper. Why? Who knows? But it's a clue that nothing in this box is as simple as it looks. And here's the phone. Right away, magnification shows a gap between the white plastic back and the aluminum unibody. It's wider than I expected. But then, we move to the antenna line around the camera plateau, and the opposite is true. The plastic is perfectly molded to the metal, zero gaps. This level of precision is likely a mold-in-place process. Impressive. The anodized coating on the plateau shifts from matte to reflective depending on the angle, an interesting optical property. But let's get to the main event. The ultra-wide lens is the reason I bought this phone. I plan to test its macro capabilities next. It's coated so dark, it hides everything behind it. Only with added light do the internal details appear, along with more dust speckles. We're talking about the inside dust here. The outside particles? They're on me, of course. Now, the main camera. And it's the same story. A whole cloud of micro dust particles floating at different depths reminds me of a constellation of stars in the sky. So beautiful. The flash isn't just an LED, it's a complex diffuser with a conical ripple effect. The rear microphone. It's not just a hole, it's a crater. And the chamfered edge has a honeycomb-like structure. We can even see the circular tool marks from the chamfering bit. This means it was drilled after the anodization. The LiDAR scanner? An absolute black void. No light penetrates it. The action button? More dust. This could be from my environment. I can't blame the factory for this one. Still, I haven't touched it yet, mind you. The new camera button? Same thing. But the build is interesting. It looks like a glass inlay with a stainless steel border. The bottom components? The speaker grates are clean. For now. This is the last time they'll ever look this nice. The screw? It's a Pentalobe, of course, but look at the surface. Circular waves like a water ripple. The USB-C port. A mesmerizing, perfect fit of steel, plastic, and aluminum, laser engraved with its part number inside. Turning to the front, the speaker gap between the screen and the aluminum housing hides a protective plastic insert with holes. With enough light, we see the front camera. And yes, you guessed it, another dust cloud. But that's not the story. The real story is the display itself. Look at the pixels. This is the ProMotion XDR display at the subpixel level. This is not art. This is microengineering on an insane scale. You are looking at the individual red, green, and blue subpixels. The blue element is the largest square. The red is smaller. The greens are rectangles. Each one is secured by what appears to be gold-plated copper contacts. And the entire array is overlaid with a separate grid that is almost certainly the touch sensor. Look at the edge of the dynamic island cutout. They have perfectly terminated the pixel array at the edge. No wasted components. From dust trapped in the lenses to microscopic engravings in the USB-C port, the iPhone 17 Pro is both a showcase of engineering and a reminder that perfection doesn't exist.